We're visiting Xinjiang, a delegation of ambassadors from Eurasian countries and at the same time countries of Shanghai Cooperation Organization. We invited by the government of Xinjiang province, and we had good chance to visit beside Urumqi. We visited Kashgar and Aksu. These three important cities of Xinjiang province, which played important role during centuries, thousand years on the Silk Road, connecting China with the Central Asian and Asian and European countries. We're now about the role of these cities in implementing the initiative of chairman of China and His Excellency President of China, Mr. Xi Jinping, One Belt, One Road. In implementing this initiative, Xinjiang province and these cities, and these three cities playing important role. That's why for me it was very interesting to see how it's developing, first of all, and how these ethnic groups living together and peace and stability. It was important for me too, because here living more than 50 ethnic groups in these regions. And at the same time, it was important to look how it was possible to eliminate the extremistic and terroristic activity in this region, because Xinjiang have close interconnection with the SCO countries and first of all with Central Asia. My impression certainly how it is growing very rapidly, economy of this region. And only last years, from 2015 to 2019, GDP of this region growing from more than 900 billion yuan to 1.4, perhaps 4 billion, trillion yuan. Every year, more than 7% growth of GDP. And this is not only figures. It is concrete construction of new enterprises, industry, new industry. One only example that Xinjiang region, the, one of the leader in the alternative energy, solar energy and wind energy, and at the same time Xinjiang providing 90 province of China by electropower. So we could see this, how it is growing agriculture in this country, how it modernization of agriculture. We witness it, how it is modernized, how it is used, new technology in agriculture, for example, unmanned planes for spreading fertilizers, or at the same time, a satellite system for monitoring on the situation in land area. So it's a very more interesting things could see there, but more impressing when you riding by car or flying by plane, we could see this everywhere going construction, apartments, and we could see the new constructed enterprises and the same time going on this construction. But the same time, what impressed the tourist infrastructure.
Tourist
infrastructure, and impressing that construction and quality of roads. I worked perhaps 13 years in European countries, and I can say that the quality of the roads in all area, in all cities which we visited, the high quality, world standards quality of these roads. And as in China saying, if you would like to be rich, you should construct the roads. And that's why I think it is one of important result of reforms and economic development of Xinjiang, that all region have such infrastructure. We could see this modernization of this area in communication system, in infrastructure for electricity, gas, and water supply. 100% of people is supplied by this important
100%.
Issue. 100%, as a mayor of city told me, because he said, because Xinjiang region have its own gas and one of the biggest producer of the gas in the China. But at the same time in Kashgar, we could see the center for water pumping, center for supplying the population with the water. Mm-hmm. It is impressive. During 1 year, it was constructed this system, new system. and more than perhaps 300 kilometers of pipelines constructed, and at the same time, clean water to every family, to every home, to all ethnic and to all citizens, regardless their ethnicity, this supplied, and we could see how it was used before. I can say that I'm impressed by the development of Urumqi, the city, central city of province, because there is metro station, 18 kilometers and 32 остановки,
stops.
It is special 18 kilo, 32. But now, as the mayor of city informed me, that they now under construction 20 new kilometers of metro. So I can say some developed countries have not such